What's up, guys? Welcome back to Subnautica. Today, the hunt for silver continues. I really want to get this fragment analyzer so we can see about getting that sea moth. I do want to try to move this rock. I don't know if there's, like, another way into this cave. I don't even know if there is a cave down there. You know, let's see if there's another way into the cave. I got kind of curious what was down there. I started using it as, like, a dump. I guess maybe this lets me get over there. Okay. I think I hear that little rubber sound. That the fish, yep, there's one right there. Go, 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 go. Nice. Okay. We can outrun them, or at least they go as fast as me. So it seems like I'll be able to handle these guys now. I'm curious. Okay, that rock does go right here. Alright, cool. Alright, well, maybe we'll find some formations and stuff in here. I don't think we've ever been in here. I think I heard another one of those little rubber sounds. Ooh, we got dark. We got super dark. This is kind of neat. I mean, this is like right under our house. Crap. Oh god! He straight up killed me! Wow, I was not expecting that. Oh my goodness. That's ridiculous. Alright, let's see if we can move this rock so we have quicker access to it. Where are you? Like a little bioluminescent shrimp thing that I'm murdering for literally no reason. I might have some of those floater guys in here. I do. Is this enough to move this rock? Maybe. I don't know. No. No, it is not. Well, that sucks. Maybe we'll be able to find some more. I do need to get some fish while we're down here because I guess dying took half my food away. So yeah, we'll get some food while we're here. In fact, let's just I mean we know there's an entrance here. Can I just dig the sand away to get down there? Come on now. Are you gonna let me? I don't think it's gonna let me. This is kind of working. Kind of. In fact, I don't think it's working at all, but I'm gonna keep telling myself it's working. Yeah, the cave is over there. I don't think I can dig straight into a cave, so that's fine. That's okay. That's alright. Everything's fine. It's okay. We just need to not get hit by it. We need to find him and run. We can't let him touch us. Forgot where he was. I think he was down there. Because there's the rock. Okay, so he was down here somewhere. Actually, since he launched himself at me, he shouldn't be down here anymore, should he? Okay, no, he's not. He's gone. Okay, that's good. Just checking for any other ones. Okay, let's break them. Alright. Alright. Better. Whoa. I'm surprised at how dark it is in here. Please don't be anymore. Or, yeah, don't be anymore. Oh, there he is, right there. I think we can win this fight, but we're gonna hold off. Crap, we're gonna die again. We're gonna die again. Ow! What a jerk! I think I made a health kit at least. I didn't. I already used the health kit I made. Crap. This isn't safe at all. There's another one. You guys are dicks. Was there one in here? Okay, yes. I want to try to outrun this one. I don't know if he's following me, but we need to leave anyways.
Emergency. 10 seconds of oxygen.
There we go. Okay. Alright, I'm gonna see if we have the stuff to make a first aid kit. Those guys are rude. Oh my goodness. That is silly. I don't know why they're so upset or grumpy or hostile, whatever you want to call it. Okay, we need coral and salt. So what's in here? We're actually out of salt completely. That's interesting. Some quartz at least. Right, let me dump this stuff in here. Let's put these in there. Put these in there. Alright, we need to go get food. And we need to go get salt. And we need some coral. Yes. And it's nighttime. And we need floater pods. Everything's going well, guys. Everything's going super well. This is an excellent start. I really, really want to be able to eat you at some point. Oh, I killed him for no reason. Alright, well, we can at least eat these bladderfish. So that's okay. I think we can actually also turn them into those little air sac sort of things. That way we can move the rock and have easier access. Ooh, there's one. Has. Aha. I keep hearing that little sound, like, I guess maybe there's a cave under me. That's probably pretty likely. I'm sad that I killed that one larger fish and I couldn't even eat him. Some manatees. Okay, I know which way we're going. We're going along the ship. Yeah, we are. Alright, well, I think I'm going to leave you guys for a moment because all I'm going to be doing is swimming around looking for fish to catch, and I'm going to be trying to get my hands on some salt so we can make a first aid kit because we are almost dead. So I will see you guys in just a moment. Okay, guys, I lied. The hunt for food turned into the hunt for silver. This area looks neat. I figured I'd bring you guys back just in case something magical happens. We're swimming over here near these manatee things. They can totally hear us, or we can totally hear them. Their beautiful sad, sad song. Please stay over there. Stay away from me. I know you're probably friendly and you just want hugs, but I'm afraid to give hugs to things in this game. Because the first thing I ever saw, I tried to give a hug to, and he exploded in my face. How full are we? We're not super full up. Well, yeah, I was down in this. Fragment? What kind of fragment are you? Another sea moth fragment. I certainly don't need all of this food. And unfortunately, I haven't found any salt yet. I think for these right here, though, come here. I can at least store them in my aquarium for right now, until I need to cook them. I made a mistake. No. I'm bad. Oh, and what is this? Oh, that's a mushroom. That's right. I remember dropping you. I guess I just kind of swam along and littered all over the place. There's got to be silver down in these caves. I don't think they would put the seamoth fragments that close and then make you have to travel for so far just to get silver to start working on getting your seamoth up. That doesn't make sense. So I think we need to try to explore these caves. So for right now, I'm going to put in these little peeper fish, and we'll eat these guys. We'll probably need to eat more than that. We'll make some water out of these, and we also have that floater that we can go put over there. So let's get some water coming in. That'll top us off with the food pretty nicely. And let's cook some boomerangs. I guess we only have one of them. No, we have more than one of them. Okay, cool. So we'll see what this does for us. Cook boomerang. There we go. I guess we could eat one of these. Or two of them. What else can I do with you? How do I turn you into like an air sac? Can I do that? For some reason I thought I could. But maybe I was up an air bladder. Maybe I should make one of these. You know what? Let's make one of those. Maybe that'll help me get to the... I mean, I would hope it would help me get to the surface faster. So let's go to tools. I mean, I hope it's not like a single-use thing. Let's eat our cooked air sac. I think I just ate a raw air sac because my water went down. That's okay, though. That's alright. Apparently, I have 4 survival knives now. I don't even know how that happened. I had 1. I'll take it, though. I'll take it. I'm going to put you there. Actually, no. I'm going to put you there. Okay. That's weird. That's super weird. Okay, and I can't do anything with you. All right, so then you can go there for right now. We'll see if we can move the rock. We still need salt, but, you know, this will be a good experiment, too. Let's put you there. Not even a little bit. What if I, like, are you stuck? I try to dig you out some. No, you just keep sinking. Okay, so we need a lot. What about this guy? Oh, that's really nice. I totally should have built one of these so long ago. Oh my goodness. That is incredible. Alright, I'm gonna put my flashlight as 5. I'm mad at myself, guys. It's okay, though. It's part of the fun. It's part of learning. Alright, so we're good on food. We're good on water. We still need salt, so we can make some bleach, so we can make... a first aid kit. But we're getting there, guys. We're getting there. I guess at this point, I'm going to go ahead and pause the recording again and just kind of walk around, or not walk around, but swim around in our local area to see if I can find some salt, and I will be sure to bring you back in case anything interesting happens. We have so many fishies. Guys, they're practically in a refrigerator. They are practically in a refrigerator. I really think there's going to be stuff in these caves that are underneath me. It's just, I don't have the HP to deal with those guys right now, the grumpy fish. Like, are there any in here? I don't see and or hear any. Maybe I won't bring you guys back. Maybe I'll just leave you guys here. I would imagine this is a pretty relaxing game to watch. just because of the audio and the environments. There's nothing in here. That was sad. That's okay. Maybe we'll go over to the kelp forest where all the sharks are. Or not the sharks, I keep forgetting what they're called. I just need to make up my own name for them and stop calling every fish I find grumpy fish. Because that's most of them, I guess. I mean, at least it feels like that's most of them. Our beacon. We'll explore this area a little bit. There's a lot of caves underneath us. And then the kelp forest is over there as well. Are there any little minerals just kind of poking out? Doesn't look like it. Hopefully there aren't any grumpy fish in here. I think I've kind of picked this place clean. Over the course of my adventures. Which that's a shame. Because I like this area. Have to be really, really careful about paying attention to those stalker fish. That's what they're called, stalkers. Just because we don't have the HP for it. Yeah, like down in here, it seems like there would be some silver. It seems like a good place for silver, at least. Just because it's like, it's near where you start, and to get to all the other places, you really need that sea moth because it just takes so long to get over there. So it would make sense that they would put silver in these areas, and I guess maybe I just haven't found it or anything. Which is, I mean, that's the most likely case. What's this? Not silver, that's what that is. How's our inventory? It's okay. We can always drop some of this stuff. I'm glad we got that extra tank, too. No grumpy hiding behind the corner camping grumpy. Just checking. Seems like prime real estate for grumpy. Bring Gary. I like you, you're slow. It works out for me. It works out really well for me. You know what? Let's draw out our new air bladder. That works pretty well. I approve. Even more so. I will say that, that exploring in this game, even just, not necessarily exploring, but even just going around and getting the crafting materials you need is pretty enjoyable, just because the environment, the underwater environment, all the plant life looks nice, the fish look nice, the sound is really well done, the music's nice. I mean, I would kind of compare this to, at least for me personally, in Minecraft, for example, I really enjoyed caving, especially when I first started playing, and even like if I occasionally play it now, I still really enjoy caving. It's something about being down in that sort of almost claustrophobic type environment, and you're just, it's just you and a pickaxe trying to find some minerals so you can make awesome stuff. That's kind of what I would compare this to. Ooh. That got super deep. Let's do it. We have our air bladder. We have to remember we have our air bladder. Ooh, is that salt? We totally need salt. We have to be careful. We'll probably get one shot if anything tries to attack us. I think I'm probably gonna... Like, why do I have so many knives? I don't understand this. What did I do to get all of these knives? I didn't make all of these knives, I know that. I guess that's a quality problem to have. Oh, I have too many knives. Ooh, what are you? It's like another fragment. A terraformer fragment. Oh, that sounds awesome. This place looks really cool. Let's fill up on air, and then we'll kind of just hang out in here in this area for the last few minutes of the show. Goodbye, Gary Fish. There's a grumpy fish in there. I see you. See you. Oh, that's so far down. We should be good. Let's go. We gotta be careful around these guys. I'm gonna turn the HUD back on so I can just kind of keep an eye on our HP. I think we'll be fine because it's daytime and they're over there playing with the metals. But we're gonna have to keep an eye on them. Okay, so we're gonna need to drop stuff. I'm gonna go ahead and drop the Seamoth fragment. We have a lot of them. I'm also going to drop some of this titanium that we have because, I mean, it's just so abundant. Which, it's a good thing. It's a good thing it's so abundant. Some salt. Definitely need the salt more than anything. Another fragment down there, as well as one of the little breather thingies. What are you? A workbench fragment. Oh, that's really cool. Can I have some air, please? I'm trying to make sure I don't die. Ooh. That looks kind of scary. I'm gonna be honest with you guys. That looks kind of scary. Just more titanium. Alright, I think we might get our beacon and move it over here. This is... Anyway, I guess if we call the ship north, I guess this is like southwest.
Warning, 30 of the ship. Of oxygen remaining.
No problem, Sheila. We got this covered. Totally covered. Okay, so from our pod, if we called it north, this would be like southeast. This would be like east. Like east, east, southeast. Does I have to fill back up if I... Okay. So I can leave it full. That's kind of cool. I really, really want to get some Leave me alone. Alright, we'll go back. We'll go back. We got salt. Why are you playing that creepy sound? Stop playing that creepy sound, game. Let's get out of here. We'll come back this way. We know where this is now. It'll be pretty easy for us to get back here. Yeah, okay, so that's like straight east of our ship then. So we'll make a med kit and top off. And then we'll head back that way. I guess not a bad day's work, I suppose. Did we get another floater for this? No, we didn't. That's okay though. We have another place we can go explore. So that's all right. Thank you. I like that you call me Captain, random computer lady. Can I make bleach? No, I need coral samples. I'm out of coral samples. Crap. Okay, well, we can at least eat some Gary fish, eat some boomerang. We can store our fragments. So right now we have a bunch of steam moth fragments, we have some stasis rifle fragments, a workbench fragment, that's pretty cool. A terraformer fragment also sounds pretty cool. We have a lot of knives. I'm gonna go ahead and store two knives. We have some quartz, which we'll just kinda hang on to for right now. Just put all this in here. Nope, keep the salt. There we go. Alright, so we're gonna go get some coral. Yes. And I don't think we can... Yeah, we can't use that coral. We have to use the green coral. Because that is something... That's for something else. Giant coral tubes. That doesn't help. This coral right here. This is the kind of coral we need. Come on now. Let me grab you. There we go. Alright. 5 coral samples. That's enough to make... we should have enough to make a couple med kits at least. And maybe a bottle of water as well. We're getting all of these fragments and we have nothing to analyze them with. Kind of sad. Alright, let's go ahead and make some bleach. Let's make some more bleach. Just keep making bleach. I guess at some point, once we get a good enough amount of salt stored up, I'll start making some cured fish to keep on me. But for right now, I think this will be okay. I think we also need like creeper vine or something to make a fish. Or not a fish, to make a health kit. Yeah, okay, so we're gonna need to get some more of those too. So we can make one health kit right now. There's our bottle of water, there's our health kits. Oh, that's so much better. That is so, so, so much better. This works. That worked really well. Alright, let's get one more thing of bleach. No, we can't. We're out of salt, actually. Alright, we'll store this bleach and that coral sample. Alright guys, I think that's going to wrap up this episode. In the next episode, we're going to go back out towards that little, I don't know what I want to call it, the little crimson shelf area. And see if we can find some silver. We got a lot of nice fragments. We got some, a new workbench fragment, we got some weapon fragments, and we got some, a terraformer fragment. So we got a lot of cool stuff that we're just kind of waiting on the silver for. So that's going to wrap this one up. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it. And as always, thanks for watching. And have a good one.